Good evening and good morning, everyone. I'm Wen-Yang Peng. You can call me Steven. Today, I would like to talk about the high payload multi-rotor drones, its opportunities and challenges. I work at the Mechanical and Mechatronics System Research Laboratory in ITRI. ITRI here we have six core labs and also some focus centers, and we have many patents and startups here.
Okay, 在工业研究院，我们有六到七个实验室，然后主要是专注在这些研究中心。
Lately we try to figure out the technology strategy toward 2030. One of the most more important topic is about smart living.
最近我们最近主要的科技呢，是在面对到2030年的未来的科技，那主要是智能科技。
So today my topic about a drone is among several topics of the category of autonomous mobility.
Okay, 我们今天包含的主题，无人机的主题，除了这个自动流线型，有自动流线型。
自主移动, yeah, yeah.
Oh, 自主移动, okay.
Okay, thank you. So this is the outline of my presentation today.
这个是我主要的今天要发表的演讲的题目。
Okay. As you can see, I try to make a green mark. Including the hybrid drone and the multi-rotor drone.
你有看到我有用一个绿色的标框标出来，一个是混合机型，还有多响翼的机型。
Yeah, for the past 4 to 5 years, we ITRI team focus on the multi-rotor drone topic mostly, and for the past 2 years, we start to focus on the hybrid drone too.
过去的四五年，我们的团队主要是在研究多响翼。那过去两年呢，我们研究的是混合机翼型。So
why we spend most of our resource and time on the multi-rotor topics? This is because we found that the many unmet needs between these two ends. One end is the consumer product or some agricultural application product. And the other end is a non-utility product emerging about decades ago.
Okay, 为什么要花时间在多响翼的无人机上面呢? 除了从消费者这边，然后还有我们还有研究了 农业方面的，还有它的多功能的一些性能。
So, how do we define the so-called the high payload and long endurance drone? I think that this is a good way to study if you can put the maximum takeoff weight together with the endurance time and together with the working range, and you can find there is a relationship proportional to the cost.
那怎样去开启无人，怎样去启动无人机的话，除了它的最低。 最高限度，还有时间上的耐力，然后还有一些相关联性，相关联系的启动的程序。
Yeah, The purple area is somehow roughly about the target zone of ITRI drone team.
这个主要指测的地方是我们目标所研究的无人机。
Or we so-called the high payload utility drone.
是我们所称为的高载重无人机。
Yeah, for next generation.
也下一个世代。
Okay, right now we go to the topic about what we did, what we have done for system integration research for the multi-rotor drone.
再来我们再回到这个标题，我们做过了什么样的，我们在对于混合无人机，高载重混合，高载重多项混合无人机上面做过了什么研究？
So, as you can see, we begin roughly about 2017, and we start from some kernel modules, like the propulsion unit, and also some system integration effort on some specific applications.
我们从2017年开始做这样子的研究，然后开始研究一些相关的应用程式。
Okay. So, for the multi-rotor UAV experience of ITRI, we got some intellectual property we got some IP effort, like in the domain of power system.
Okay, 我们在我们工业研究院在多项功能多项机多项无人机功能上面，我们研究了一些智慧型的功能，像是
然后像是 IP 方面的，对，是 ，Yeah, and also including the fuselage design, the 机身设计 ，and also the ground auxiliary system, and also the navigation and controls system.
包含了机身设计之外，还有地面的设计，还有一些控制无人机的仪器。
So, we got some experience in application-oriented heavy utility drone. We have some landing gear, especially for automatic charging for the multi-rotor.
我们有些应用的技术包含是像是降落的齿轮等等的技术。
And as I mentioned that we focus on the application oriented for a specific application, we divided these multi-rotor development job into 8 categories, like a small one to medium and also very big one.
我们创造了这些无人机的引导的技术，我们分成了八项不同的小项目，有从小的，然后到中的，还有到大的。
So, for ITRI in the past 5 years, we have some infrastructure development, especially for drone R&D, and also for the POC activities, proof of concept.So, this is because we have to meet the regulation of the local government and also have very preliminary test for the local client.
过去五年，工研研究院研究了无人机 R&D 还有 POC 的活动。那我们为了要符合政府的一些规定，还有客户最初的他们对于这个无人机的一些要求。
So we have a facility, something like a I would like to especially mention to you that for utility application, sometimes you have to prove your waterproof capability for the whole drone, and also some vibration test for transportation consideration. So this is a very special facility in the development process of the utility, heavy utility drone.
在无人机发展方面呢，我们对在水波纹的检水方面的检测，还有波纹方面的检测，在对无人机的检测方面是相当重要的。
And we have the green zone for fly mission test.
我们有一些绿能源在对于无人机的测试方面。
Right now, we would like to introduce you some project experiences about our multi-rotor.
接下来我们要向您介绍多响翼无人机。
The first one is a high payload teaser drone. This one is especially for carrying some special camera and also some special communication device. In very severe, severe climate, the weather's condition.
在我们要介绍的高载重呢，主要是特别是上面的，它会承载各种可承载一些机，承载一些相机，然后还有在比较激烈的气候方面的话，要做沟通。
This drone will be deployed in very emergent situation to have to supply the communication support for rescue or some moment of some disaster situation.
我们在灾难这样子的那种无人机呢，特别是用在紧急的时刻要做紧急的沟通，或者是在灾害的时候要做紧急的救援。
So this is a very short demonstration of the development process of this kind of high payload teaser drone. Thank you for your watching. And basically speaking, in order to have very stable hovering outdoors, you have to go through very detailed tests indoors to make sure the structure stiffness and everything of the power system reliable, then you can have very robust performance outdoors.
在外面如果要它的航行要比较稳定的话呢，我们在内部 我们在室内的测试呢要非常的仔细，因为要确认好它的结构是没有问题的，所以它的那个能它的启动的能力机器人的启动能力才是没有问题的。
This is something very similar to the traditional aviation industry development.
这跟航空业是相当的类似的。
Yeah. Okay. The second one is a water jet cleaning drone. As you can see, in some situations, we would like to clean some infrastructure devices at very high altitude. So it is very beneficial to use the multi-rotor drone as it has very good hovering capability to do such kind of a very high strength water jet cleaning job.
那另外一个是洒水设计，因为我们在洒水在很多建筑方面呢是比较高的，需要做洒水设计。那这对多翔无人机来说是非常的有用的，它在这个方面是非常有用处的。
是，对，多旋翼，对。
哦，多旋翼，好。
好。OK。Okay, the third one we would like to introduce is about the technology for delivery drone at open field. As everyone knows that the AI technology right now, nowadays, very closely related to the drone development technology. And, okay.
我们都知道多旋翼，另外还有一个上设计呢，是主要是外送服务的设计。我们都知道，API 应用程式界面和多旋翼无人机息息相关。
So in the open field, we may have a station for auto landing. So you have to detect, automatically about the location or the alignment of the.The drone for very safe landing.
Okay, 在开放的地区呢，我们要让多旋翼无人机能够侦测这个环境是安全的，可以自动降落的。
And another topic is the agricultural drone.
另外一个呢是农业无人机。
As I mentioned here, the application is about a chemical spray.
它主要的应用呢是喷洒药剂。
And also, it can serve for the fertilizer or other kind of seed spray.
主要还可以做施肥的功能，还撒种的功能。
Yeah. We have the original functional prototype for the 30 liter tank version. It has a spray span up to 3.5 meter.
我们有原型，这个是36公吨，然后它的喷洒的范围是大于 3.5 公尺。
30公升的药桶。
30公升。
Yeah, okay. We also have a smaller one like a 10 liter or even with some smart spray function.
我还有比较小的10公升的，然后它的喷洒的范围是比较相对小一点。
So right now, after we reviewed some experienced project,about our multi-rotor drones, we would like to introduce you our technology focus about the multi-rotor drone.
在看过了我上述分享的多旋翼经验，接下来我们再介绍更多的多旋翼的科技。
Yeah, as you can see that the if you need to have very stable hovering or takeoff transition control, you need the basic of the powertrain and the fuselage together to have your drone to deliver very stable performance.
如果你要起飞是很，如果要很稳定的去起飞，而且并且航行的话，在它的能力方面，机器在机身的稳定性是非常重要的。
And today, everyone is noticing about the efficiency of the drone. So the working range and or the hovering time is becoming more and more important.
再来，目前大家比较注意到是多响多旋翼无人机它的工作效能，还有它能够航行多久。
The basic idea is to have more, is to have better energy densities, power source.
主要的，我们最主要的观点就是在它的电池的续航力是需要相当够的。
Something like we can use the fuel powered hybrid power unit.
像是混合动力汽油之类的。
Yeah, and of course we need to improve the propulsion efficiency of the drone.
当然，我们在它的功效能方面也是需要做相当的进步。
So, as you can see in the example of the high payload test a drone, as we need to deploy in emergent situations, so the transportation is very important. So we designed some foldable and a very quick deployment mechanism design.
你可以注意到多旋翼在急救方面，急救的交通方面是需要反应特别快的，所以我们在它的反应速度。它的反应速度的机器上面会相当注重。
Yeah, usually it's a contradiction for compact and high payload design.
这跟它的高载重有相当的抵触的关系。
But we have very good joint design to figure this problem.
但是我们在面临它这样抵触的问题，我们想出了一个方法来解决。
And as we mentioned the propulsion efficiency of the propeller unit, we have some kernel technology about the motor itself, and also the driver, and also the integration design of the propulsion unit, that is about the propeller loading curve and the motor performance curve.
在我们刚刚有提到说它必须要有效率的，所以我们在马达还有它的开无人机方面，我们在它的滑翔翼及它的黄小翼的弯曲度这边有下了不少功夫。
And as we mentioned about the better energy density power source, one of the good option which is more commercially available is a fuel powered hybrid power system.
在电池方面，我们找到比较好效能的就是混合油电的电池。
Yes, many people is talking about the hybrid power for the drone.
很多人在讲混合油电的无人机。
The hydrogen fuel cell is one of the options.
不好意思，再说一次，我没有听到。
The hydrogen fuel cell is one of the options.
水力电呢，这个是其中的一项选择。
Yeah, 氢燃料电池 ，Yeah，
氢燃料电池。
But right now, the fuel-powered hybrid unit is more cost-effective.
现在的这个汽油是相当在花费方面相当有效能的。
And more technology matured.
这也比较偏向高科技，是想有成刚的 cost effect 成本效益，不好意思。
Okay. Yeah, for the multi-rotor drone, as we know that it has auto balance function, but we also have to care about how if one or two more motors just fail and how to regain balance and also reconfigure your mission.
多旋翼呢，它有自动的平衡的功能，但是我们也是需要去特别关注到，万一它的马达失效的话，应该要怎么样去解决
？Yeah, we have a special adjusted software to figure this kind of problem, to ensure that you can have very emergent automatic self landing.
所以我们有特别的软体来解决。这个在紧急的时候突然要降落，在紧急的时候如何自动降落的稳定
？Okay, so right now we jump into the topic about a hybrid fixed wing, eVTOL technology. So. For this kind of hybrid fixed wing drones, or sometimes we just call it the vertical takeoff and landing drone or UAV, for such kind of topic, we just aim to make the eVTOLs tangible for utility application.
在多旋翼的无人机上面，我们也可以称作叫做水平无人机。那它在它的性能，它在它的主要它的性能方面是要让它不好意思 ，eVTOL 是多旋翼无人机吗？
对，电推进，
只要是电推进，只要是让它能够电推进的，然后
垂直起降，
主要是让它能。只要是让它能够垂直起降，
对，hybrid fixed wing 复合翼，
复合翼 ，OK， 好
，OK， as you can see from the figure that for the existing technology or prior art, we can find that for utility purpose, we still have to conquer about the endurance and payload problem.
在效能方面，我们还是要去我们还是在针对它的高载重方面，还有它的效能方面，要去达到一个平衡。
So the most important issue is that we have to improve the aerodynamic efficiency of such kind of eVTOL fuselage, and also we have to figure out the flight control methodology for such kind of a novel fuselage.
我们在航空推动方面，还要针对它的，我们要针对这个无人机去做控制，然后去做它的去做好的控制及它的革新。
So first, I would like to mention about the propulsion design and the flight control agility.
再来我要介绍的是它的推力，而且还有它飞行的控制。
So the propulsion design, as you can see, for the left bottom figure.
再来它的推力，来看到它的推力设计，我们来看到它左边的这个图。
So you have to care about the hovering efficiency and also the hovering design volume.
我们要 你必须要特别去注意到它的飞行的效率。
That is, as we know, for the helicopter or the single rotor design, you have very efficient hovering capability.
你知道，像是直升机或者是单向的，或者是单翼的无人机，他们在飞行的时候是非常有效率的。
But something like the existing fighter jet, something like the AB-8, AB-8B, they have very good vector air jet design.
那现在的这样子的战斗力呢？他们有很好的 AB 我不太确定是什么。
AB-8B 是一种机型，对。
机型，OK，它是一个很好的机型，好。
So, if you want to have very compact design, very neat design like AB-8B.
如果你想要有一个像 ABAB 具有影响力的设计，
Usually you have to sacrifice your efficiency.
你必须要牺牲它的效率。
So we have we try to pursue such kind of compromise solution.
我们尽量去追求这样子退一步的解决办法。
Something like the tiltrotor or tailwind solution.
像是后机翼或是后滑翔翼，
前转旋翼或前转机翼
前转旋前转，OK，好。
But usually, for such kind of a propeller design, it is not very beneficial to utility application.
像是这样子的这个。螺旋桨呢，它对于在效能方面并不是有很大的利益。
So right now we are trying to embed the propulsion unit inside the fuselage.
我们现在要迁入 propulsion 这个设计。propulsion
And also not to sacrifice the efficiency too much.
而且不要太牺牲它的效能。
So this is the basic idea of our design philosophy.
这个主要是我们最终的目的地。
So, one of our technology approach is to develop a very efficient electric ductive fan.
我们。第一个比较有效率的方法是如何去达到这样子的效果。
We call it EDF, electric ductive fan. So we would like to put this electric ductive fan inside the eVTOL distributed at some corner.
我们想要把这个电力的这个电扇呢，去装到这个 EDF 里面。
So then you will have very well distributed vector jet for the eVTOL. Then you can have a stable takeoff and some aviation control.
它在矢量方面呢，会比较有稳定的起飞，然后在航空方面也比较相对的稳定。
So the first challenge is that you have to improve the EDF thrust density.
主要的第一个的挑战呢是，主要第一个挑战呢是 EDF 的触动能力。触动电力，触动电力。
Yes, if we can improve the thrust density of EDF, then you will have similar performance compared to the traditional oil-powered micro-gas turbine.
如果能够在推力 EDF 这方面做得很好的话, 那就可以与传统的油电来相比。
So the target is to have a maximum thrust of 40 kilogram output capability of each EDF.
最主要的目的是最多至少要有 40克的 EDF 推动力。
Okay. Usually we request that the EDF can deliver 40 kilogram to sustain at least 10 seconds.
我们至少 EDF 要递送 40公斤, 然后并且维持 稳定性 10秒钟。
And the rated thrust will be at 25 kilogram.
而它的频量区测是在 25公斤。
Yeah, so the compromise efficiency will be around 2 gram per watt.
而它的不好意思，可以再一次吗？ 这个是
Yeah, the compromised efficiency of the thrust unit will be 2 gram per watt.
每瓦特它的推动能力是在进退一步的话是在每瓦特每两瓦特
Yeah, this is about 50% of the traditional propeller for very high thrust output.
这个是 50% 螺旋桨的推动能力。
This is some EDF tested development inside our laboratory. We use 6 EDF for preliminary test of the eVTOL study.
这是我们实验室所做的多旋翼的测试。 那我们用6个 EDF 来做最初的一个试验。
So, we are trying new vector airjet configuration to have more stable hovering and takeoff.
我们用比较新的螺旋桨，让它在起飞跟降落的时候都起飞跟航行的时候都可以比较稳定。
And another issue of eVTOL design is about the flight control.
另外一个多旋翼的议题我们需要去讨论的就是它的飞航控制。
Yeah, in order to develop a very customized flight control for the innovative eVTOL, we need a simulation platform.
为了要更贴近它的所创新的这个多旋翼，所以我们需要有一个模拟的系统，模拟的平台。
For this example, we tried the blended wing body fuselage.
在这个实验里面，我们用了这个，不好意思， blended wing 是机身机翼融合的设计。
We try to input 3 models in this simulation platform.
我们放了三个模型在这个实验里面。
And we have a optimized solution after quick simulation.
我们有比较最恰当的解决办法，我们就比较快、比较切恰当的解决办法。
That is to keep efficiency of the cruise mode and also to keep the lateral stability control.
主要是让它的在航行的效能是很顺利的，然后还有它的平衡感要保持得很好。
Okay, this is very interesting to do many, many flight simulation. And this is a kind of integration of the commercial software and also some API.
Okay, 这是非常，这算是非常非常有趣的这个模拟的这算是非常非常有趣的模拟飞行。那它在这个产业来说是在这个产业来说是相当有趣，相当有效率。
Yeah, you can also simulate the synchronous landing on the deck.
你也可以能够，你也能够模拟它降落在甲板上。
Okay, thank you for your patience. This concludes my presentation. I do not have any conclusion or I just ask for open discussion. If you have any questions, I would like to discuss with you about any topic of the drone.
感谢你的参与，如果有任何问题的话都可以询问我，也很感谢你参加这次无人机的会议。
Okay, Mr. Peng, here is a question I want to ask. We actually can see that the ITRI drones is on the cutting edge of technology and much bigger beyond our conditions. And it does the highly potentials on the drone applications. And the drone that ITRI designs is actually does, you know, just which is made in Taiwan with so-called MIT. And the application is very wide, right? Wide range. And my question is, did the ITRI drones actually do another applications in practical for the government needs or private enterprise needs? Except for agricultures and 3D survey mapping technology.
Yeah, sure. Here, the drone research activities are driven by two kind of demand. One demand is from each side. We just actively propose some topics that we need to study in advance. As you mentioned, that we need to find the unmet need or pain point of the drone industry. And another situation is that we have to solve the currently existing problems of the industry. So yes, we have already two cases. One case is about the high payload tester drone. This is proposed by the government side. And another situation is the insulator of the grid tower. They have to clean the insulator. So we are also co-working with the industry side to try to solve the dilemma of the insulator cleaning job right now, because the existing traditional helicopter, they stopped their service for the Taipower company. So I think that if possible, we would like to have more requirement statement from the industry side that what kind of technology we surely can accelerate the development of the application together with the demand side. I just proposed the two example of our drone development case initiated by the government and also the industry side.
Okay, thanks for your reply. And I want to ask another question is, do ITRI drones have any potentials to create a drone, you know, the small size like DJI drones, but it can capable of using by the applications. Do we have any potential?
Yeah, some people discuss about this similar topics in the past 2 years because people are noticing about the supply chain issue about such kind of photo taking drones or surveillance drone. We know that there are already new startups like Skydio or some other drone companies have face-to-face competition with DJI to get more government project. And I think that in Taiwan, inside this industry, we have 100% capability to have such kind of integrated solution to provide the advanced product for next generation. Something like we learn from Skydio, because Skydio claims that they have the AI function for photo taking or surveillance, something differentiation from DJI product. So I think that for hardware is 100% definitely no problem here. We can have every component supplied here. But for software, we have to make very good integration and software design for the customer. I suggest that we do not begin from the universal purpose, but we begin from some special customer or special purpose to have the system development more intact and more thorough test of your system. Then after one or two round of this kind of process, I think that the Taiwanese drone companies, they can also provide a very tangible or practical or a very good product in this field. This is just my comment, yeah.
Okay, so the problem is the software is not that in common use, right?
Not in common use. You mean the software for special purpose?
Yeah, the software have to decide for special purpose.
Yeah. As we learn from the Amazon case or some other drone practice case, I think you also know that it's very important to have very customized functional payload interface and some software integration effort for some special application. So I think that we have 100% confidence on hardware, but you also have to put more, also much effort on the hardware development for some special case because the integration including the hardware and the software. So I think that the fuselage or propulsion unit is itself is not a very big problem, but the functional payload and also some the sensor interface and also the software, and you need to have very good edge computing and also use such kind of communication facility support. I think that this is our opportunity right now to use such kind of 5G or Wi-Fi mesh technology and also with edge computing together and to do some very innovative application.
Okay, thanks for your reply. And after seeing your PPT, and we actually see ITRI Drone has done the great jobs on the drone design. And we believe that the drone developed in Taiwan would be making any progress via the ITRI Drone. And thank you for your sharing.
Thank you for your encouragement, and we will keep working, and we also welcome many parties to conquer the problem together with us. Yeah.
Okay, thank you. And all right, and this is the end of today's meeting. Did anyone want to ask any questions? Or we could just end this.